The anatomy of the cow is important to know so you have an idea of the structures you are feeling when in the rectum and have an idea of where to place the insemination gun. When looking at the external genitalia of the cow, the main areas of interest are the anus, where your hand will enter the animal, and the vulva, where the AI gun will be inserted. Looking at the reproductive tract, we can see the vulva is the external genitalia that leads into the vagina. After the vagina, we come to the cervix. After the cervix, we come to the uterine body. The uterine horns follow the uterine body, which then lead to the fallopian tubes, or the oviducts, that end in the ovary. Now let's take a look at each one of these areas in more detail. The vagina is the copulatory organ and provides the site of sperm deposition by the bull. In regards to artificial insemination, the passing of the rod or the AI gun through the vagina and cervix is needed because the straw of semen being used has significantly less sperm cells and lacks accessory fluids needed to pass through the cervix. The vagina is also important in artificial insemination because it leads to the bladder. Cows do not appreciate it when you stick an AI gun in their bladder. The next organ you will encounter is the cervix. The purpose of this organ is to create a barrier to protect the uterus from foreign bodies, which will include your artificial insemination gun. The cervix is a firm structure that varies in size. The identifying characteristics of the cervix is the presence of folds or rings, which can be felt through palpation. The cervix is often compared to the neck of a chicken, or the trachea. The uterine body is the next structure you will come to after the cervix. The uterine body is not very large in cattle. Semen is deposited into the uterine body when breeding by artificial insemination. The next structure is the uterine horn. Cattle have two uterine horns, each leading to an ovary. The embryo will develop in the uterine horn, giving this organ the name organ of pregnancy. There is an oviduct attached to the end of each uterine horn. The oviduct is known as the site of fertilization because sperm is required to swim to the oviduct where it will meet the egg for fertilization. The final structure in the female anatomy is the ovary. The ovary is responsible for creating the ova or the eggs that are released and hopefully eventually fertilized by semen.